afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show, and today is Wednesday. We're not going to have it in the kitchen because we are on the road, and we have broccoli in the fridge.
That's it.
We have broccoli, and we have unripe pears. So that's all we have. If you guys can come up with something delicious between the two of those, wonderful. I don't have a problem just eating the stuff, but, you know, for you guys, I know sometimes you guys want something a little more substantial than, you know, me cutting up a piece of broccoli and then eating a pear afterwards. It doesn't really lend for good TV. But anyway, before we get into questions, because I do have a few questions and to answer for you guys. Whoa, someone's mad. But what we're gonna do is I want to show you something cool. Since I'm not really like a huge techno geek, but I do kind of like some tech stuff. So we got a wide angle lens for the flip camera now. So watch this. So you got me here, and then wide angle.
Whoa.
See how much more you can see? How much can you see here?
Yeah.
Here?
No.
Here.
There.
Yeah. No. Watch. See. Again.
Nope.
Not even close. So now you'll be able to see more of us.
Whoa.
When we film the Renegade Health Show as well, see more of the scenery that we're going to be around when we're filming. But anyway, I know none of you care about that. I do. I think it's cool. But anyway, here we go. Let's get on with the question today. Posting about coffee the other day, and people had some questions about it, and so I am glad to answer them for you. So Brian asks, what about tea? Is it much better for you than coffee is? So, you know, as you guys have read my argument for coffee, against drinking coffee, the component that I'm really not excited about, the main component, is the caffeine. Now, decaffeinated coffee has a whole nother, there's a whole nother set of things associated with that, and I'm not going to talk about that today. Maybe I'll put something together for you guys in the next couple weeks that'll be in more detail as to decaffeinated and why you probably shouldn't drink that either. But when it comes to teas, green teas and black teas, black tea sometimes has more caffeine than some coffees. Other times it has less, but it still has a lot of caffeine. And green tea has caffeine as well. So there are, again, antioxidants in these products, in these foods, teas. But again, you're still dealing with the caffeine. And because we're so stimulated because of our what we do on a regular basis. So, you know, us as humans have never experienced this amount of stress from work, from relationships, from, you know, anywhere else, stimulus from advertisements and TV and internet ads and internet headlines and news and all that sort of stuff. Caffeine is something that will overstimulate you on top of the overstimulation that you have. So black teas and green teas, I try to stay away from. And people say, "Oh, Kevin, what about the antioxidants in green tea?" Look, you can still get antioxidants from blueberries and cherries and, you know, all the different berries that are out there, and not have any of the caffeine effects from it. So I'm not going to go on just the antioxidant argument for green tea. Now, if you want to have green tea every once in a while and it doesn't make you crazy like it makes me because of the caffeine, then maybe you can have it. But I would just be careful about your caffeine intake. Herbal teas, awesome. There are plenty of herbal teas that I enjoy. I do like a tulsi, a holy basil tea. That it's not even a tea. I just take the extract and mix it in water, and I'll take that, and that's great for adrenals to cool you down. And that's a really cool tea to take. Chamomile we take all the time. I have some dried herbs over here that I'm going to prepare eventually. There's some fennel and some horsetail. Make that as a tea. This is a good way to get some of your herbal medicine or herbal nutrition. So I do like teas. I do like drinking teas. One thing you do have to be careful about teas is to make sure that you use like a tooth brightener or something like that from tooth soap, because then you won't run the risk of actually staining your teeth by drinking too much teas. And again, this applies to drinking too much green smoothie too, or green juice. So, you know, you guys know that. So just wanted to point that out. So teas are cool. Just make sure that, you know, you really look at your caffeine intake just as you would look at your sugar intake, just as you would look at your salt intake, just as you would look at your fat depending intake. So I hope that helps, Brian. Number two is Allie says, have you ever seen studies showing that organic coffee has many health benefits? All right, so So this is what I want to say, Ali. This is a great question, and there are studies out there. And as you know, where I come from in terms of studies, I'm very suspicious of where these studies are coming from. The organic coffee industry, or the coffee industry, regardless, they want you to drink more coffee. So they're going to find studies that show that coffee is good for you. And I guarantee you that these coffees are not going to study adrenal effect of coffee. So they might actually show that there are some health benefits to drinking coffee, but they will not show the adrenal effect either, which in the long term will really put your body in harm. It can, just vanity-wise, gray hair, wrinkles, things like that. Health-wise, it can slow down the production of hormones and really destroy your fight-or-flight type reaction, produce excess cortisol, massive things. Destroy your immunity and put weight around the stomach. So, if you like all those things, then drink coffee. It's cool. All right. Sorry. I just have this thing against it because I know how badly it can affect people. All right. Last question is from Reciprocity Foods. I love how you put that name in there because every time I answer a question of yours, you get a marketing plug. I love it. So, I'm curious about your opinion on coffee consumption reducing Alzheimer's. So Alzheimer's risk. So this again goes back to what I was mentioning before. I'm aware of some of these studies. There was an epidemiological study done that showed that there was correlation between coffee drinking and lower Alzheimer's, as well as some studies done on mice. In the studies done on mice, it was the equivalent of like 5 to 6 cups a day would lower your risk of Alzheimer's. And again, I would be very careful to extract that information, because 5 or 6 cups a day is definitely going to put a strain on your system. It's absolutely going to destroy and wreak havoc on your adrenals. Lastly is epidemiological studies. There are when you deal with correlations, you have to be careful, and you can't always look at just correlations, because you have to see where some of the other things that these people are doing intersect as well. So, the coffee drinkers might be eating more vegetables. Why? I don't know. But if they're eating more vegetables, what really is the correlation? Is it the vegetables and the coffee? Is it the coffee? Is it the fact that they're living somewhere where Alzheimer's doesn't tend to be prevalent as much because of the foods that they're eating? So there's large considerations that are done, and some smart epidemiological scientists know this, but I really want to warn you to trust all the information coming out from these studies, because a lot of them are picked and chosen and put together in a message that will make you want to buy something. So I hope that helps. Your question of the day is, I've asked this before, but what is your favorite tea, since we were talking about tea, since Brian asked about them? Thanks, Brian, for the question. Thanks everyone for your questions, and continue to post them. This is Kevin Chiani from the Renegade Health Show. Together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time.